Obviously, our hope and our objective and our work on the international forum is to change the behavior that is happening and the oppression that we're seeing of the people in Hong Kong. But certainly, this step is one that is meant to ensure we are practicing what we preach in terms of human rights values and ensuring that people who are in this country don't face the ongoing repression that we're seeing in Hong Kong.
Happy tears. It's like you read. I read it. I was like, wait, let me read it again. And then, you know, I think it's just like, you know, because there's a lot of, you know, pressure and stress building up in terms of, you know, about all this uncertainty, right? And then so this just sort of like opened the floodgates, and you know, just sort of like crying happy tears and talking to my friends and just feeling like, you know, it's a good feeling. Because the past 2 years has been hard for a lot of Hong Kong people. And a lot of Hong Kong people like me, that, you know, like doing study in the US, suddenly realized that we cannot go home. We don't know where we go. So I think it's a much needed good news for those of us. It's almost like in a limbo, right? You know, we're not US citizen, but we kinda, you know, have a lot of uncertainty about going back home. So it is something that, I mean, it's really, I feel elated and welcome this Biden's decision that, you know, it's not that like we got abandoned, like the US did not abandon us.
I expect that there will be retaliation, but again, this is not a punitive measure. We are saying to Hong Kongers, you are welcome in the US if you are afraid to be in Hong Kong or to return to Hong Kong. This is not about taking revenge or a punitive measure to sanction China. This is actually a humanitarian act